Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. Abdullah Oduro with Quran Q&A. We have a question here that states, why is shirk such a huge sin? Why does it put you in the hell forever? Why does it matter if I associate a partner with Allah? Why is it the equivalent of murder and adultery? Firstly, to answer this question of why is shirk such a huge sin? Well, I want us to understand one thing. For every form of creation, there are rights and responsibilities. Rights and responsibilities. So everything on this earth has a right, which by default or as a result of that or because of that is a responsibility towards another form of creation. So when we look at parents, for instance, parents have the right to be respected, to be honored, to be obeyed, to be loved. Those are their rights. And it's the responsibility of the child to respect them, to honor them, to love them. Even when we see with our supervisors or our bosses, they have the right to be respected. They have the right to be obeyed based on what is in the contract that we have sorted out. So when it comes to being on work on time, when it comes to fulfilling the tasks that you have on your contract, that is the right of the organization you work for. That's the right of the boss. That's the right of your supervisor. And it's the right of the manager to listen to what he has to say. So it's your responsibility to fulfill those rights and vice versa. As an employee, you have the right to go on break when you have agreed. You have the right to be paid your wages upon time, etc. Even when looking at forms of creation, when we see, for instance, animals, to mistreat them in a fashion that Allah has not allowed us to treat them, they have their rights, which is a responsibility for us to hold back on doing things that are detrimental to those forms of creation. When we look at the creator of the heavens and the earth, we have to look at who he is. Because everything that has a right, they have those rights because of their actions towards you, which gives you further a responsibility. So in looking at what Allah has done for creation, being that he created creation, he created it, that demands something from us. Those actions are grand and those actions are unlike any other. As a matter of fact, the creation is not able to perform those actions. This is one of the wisdom behind saying, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There is no strength or no might except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when understanding who he is very important for us. When understanding who he is and what he does, this as a result, even naturally, will place in our heart, which is already present for us, that we want to show him gratitude and want to show thanks. Just as someone was to give you a gift, and you didn't expect that the gift that they gave you would be to that degree or to that multitude. Or you did something for someone and they repay you with much more than you expect. You ask yourself, what can I do to repay you? I'm so grateful. When we look at the creator of the heavens and the earth, what he's done for us, he's given you life. He's given you sustenance. He's given you your intellect. He's given you the ability to think quickly. And he hasn't given others. Do you ask Allah, how can I thank you? He lets us know how we can thank him. Is to worship him by himself. That's the strongest form of gratitude, is to worship him by himself. And that's why it's the first pillar of Islam. The second pillar of Islam is an action of showing that gratitude. It's an action that you wouldn't just do regularly in a store or at home. It had to have been constructed by the creator of the heavens and the earth. He shows this is how you can show your gratitude amongst the many ways. But this is why shirk is the worst sin that can be committed. As Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. Verily Allah does not forgive the one that associates partners with him, and he forgives for everything other than that if he wills. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the action that is not forgiven. If one dies upon that, understanding the message of the oneness of Islam and how we worship Allah, and they voluntarily deny that, or go against that, they die upon that, does not forgive that. But he forgives everything other than that. If one was to die upon committing any other sin, with his will, if he wills, he will forgive on that sin. But we all know this is based on his will and his want, if he wants to. So understanding that shirk is the worst sin that can be committed, and with that, one may reside in the hellfire forever. But that's ultimately up to Allah. And that's why it matters if you associate a partner with Allah, because you are saying that a form of creation is equivalent to Allah from one aspect, from strength, from love, from might, from honor, from respect. If you associate a partner with Allah, it is by saying any of these qualities or characteristics is like Allah. To where I love someone to the level that I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or I pray to another person when it should only be devoted to Allah. And as we mentioned, prayer is the strongest form of gratitude, one of the strongest forms of gratitude. And why is it equivalent to murder, or that of murder or adultery? Rather, murder or adultery is definitely a sin in Islam, and it is a major sin in Islam. Why? Because you have violated a right of another person. You have violated a right of another person, therefore being negligent of your responsibility. But everyone has a right to live. And for me to take that person's life, I have violated that right. I have not fulfilled my responsibility as a human being to be a person of harmony and to be a person of safety in the vicinity of other people. And especially as a Muslim, to where I should be spreading the glad tidings to people. So murder and adultery is definitely a major sin. But the sin of worshiping others to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the worst sin that can be committed. It's the worst sin that can be committed, because that right is the ultimate right of fulfilling the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if it is violated, then that is the worst sin that can be committed. So in one aspect, it is at the level of adultery and murder. But in another aspect, it is worse than adultery and murder. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who fulfill the rights of everyone on this earth. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who worship Him by Himself and do not associate partners with Him. Put your questions in the comments below. May Allah bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.